David Stockman is former budget director for President Reagan. He joins us now to weigh in on all this. Well, it's enough to make your mind explode, unless you're David Stockman and remember a time back in the early stages of the Reagan administration when he also had a good relationship with the Teamsters Union. That blew a lot of people's minds back then as well, didn't it? David.
Well, yes, it did, but I think I wouldn't make overly much about this. Essentially, these were the building trades here today, and they're looking for construction in a big infrastructure trillion-dollar program and so forth. It's not going to happen. The U.S. government is broke today. We got a $20 trillion debt. The debt ceiling is going to expire.
But David, the president says that he's going to do it. He's going to do it with private funding. He's not going to be spending taxpayers' money to do it. So the deficit might be beside the point.
I don't think that's remotely realistic. Without big tax credits and some kind of federal infusion of capital, there's not going to be any kind of unusual infrastructure program. Beyond that, we don't have a serious infrastructure problem in this country. The federal government should take care of the interstate highways. Most of them are in good shape. They could raise the gas tax by a couple of cents and take care of any problem. Mm-hmm. The rest of it, hospitals, schools, airports, local sewer systems and so forth, that's not Washington's business. If you want to drain the swamp, you don't want to get Washington deeper into that. You want local and state
government. Well, here again, David, this is what President Obama has said, and some of his advisors have agreed with him on, particularly people like Steve Moore, who we've had sitting where you're sitting right now, saying that, in fact, what will happen is the federal government is going to be turning over a lot of the responsibilities that the feds used during the Obama administration to the local governments. So what you're saying is exactly what a lot of people working for Donald Trump are saying.
Well, I don't quite follow. I don't see that there's going to be any big fiscal stimulus. I think within weeks they're going to be in a fiscal bloodbath. When they talk about some huge tax cut, this isn't 1980. This isn't Ronald Reagan born again. This is a time when we have $20 trillion of debt, right. 106% of GDP, the opposite of what Reagan...
But we should remind our viewers, and forgive me, David, but when President Reagan announced his huge tax cuts, he had to take you to the woodshed, his words, for the fact that you didn't buy into the supply-side deal with the tax cuts back then.
Well, that's pretty much a mythological version of what happened. Of course, I bought into the supply-side tax cuts. I was one of the initial authors with Jack Kemp and a few others. But I also did not believe in a free lunch. I believed we had to match it with huge domestic spending cuts, reform of entitlements, and balancing the budget within a reasonable period of time. None of that happened. The defense buildup got totally out of control. The tax cut was 6% of GDP, far beyond anything we could afford.
Yeah, but the revenues came in full hog during the entire 1980s. Let me just switch to one thing that you may agree with Donald Trump on, and that's when it's talking about the way in which taxpayers' money is spent. Sean Spicer was talking to that point earlier. Let me just play a clip of him and see what you think about it. Play the clip.
There's been, frankly, to some degree, a lack of respect for taxpayer dollars in this town for a long time. And I think what the president's showing through the hiring freeze, first and foremost today, is that we've got to respect the American taxpayer. They're sending us a ton of money. They're working real hard. Some people are working two, three jobs just to get by. And to see money get wasted in Washington on a job that is duplicative is insulting to the hard work that they do to pay their taxes.
David, as former budget director, that must be music to your ears, no?
Yeah, I agree with the sentiment. Let me point out that on day one, when I was budget director, we froze federal hiring. For 1 year, it worked. The federal payroll went down by about 100,000 from 2.2 million. Then it rebuilt and grew until when Ronald Reagan left office in December 1988, the federal payroll was 2.3 million. It was bigger than what he inherited from big government Jimmy Carter. So the point is, the problem is Social Security. It's Medicare. It's this massive defense budget we have. Trump has already said again today, nothing on Social Security. We're not going to touch Medicare. We're going to rebuild defense. I don't know what these people are talking about.
So let me just ask a final question, David. We got to run. But if Ronald Reagan couldn't do it, drain the swamp, and if you don't think Trump could do it, could anybody do it?
I'm not sure it can be done, but someone who believes that we ought to have massive tax cuts and not pay for them, that wants more defense when we don't need it.
He thinks, as Ronald Reagan did, that they'll pay for themselves because there'll be so much more economic activity that you will eventually have a lot more tax revenue.
Well,
but I'm just putting out his side.
David, that turned out to be wrong.
A lot of people would argue with you, David, that in fact we did increase our revenues during the 1980s by 40% as a result of the more economic activity. But we could get into this. We'll talk about it in the green room after the show. We got to run. David Stockman, thank you very much.